Hello and welcome to this channel. In this video, we will quickly overview NICE updated guidelines of 2018 on the management of heart failure. This video is in particular beneficial for those preparing for MRCP-2 exam. Let's jump in. As you know, there are many drugs that are used in the management of heart failure. Some of them have mortality benefits, others are only used for symptoms improvement. We start with loop diuretics such as furosemide. Although loop diuretics play an important role in managing fluid overload and are used almost in every patient with heart failure for symptom control, it has no long-term reduction in mortality. The first-line treatment for all patients is both an ACE inhibitor and a beta blocker. Generally, one drug should be started at a time. Clinical judgment is used to determine which one to start first. Beta blockers that are used for this purpose include bisoprolol, carvedilol, and nebivolol. ACE inhibitors and beta blockers have no effect on mortality in heart failure with preserved ejection fraction. The second-line treatment is an aldosterone antagonist or mineralocorticoid receptor antagonist. For example, spironolactone and eplerenone. It should be remembered, however, that ACE inhibitors and aldosterone antagonists both cause hyperkalemia. So if a patient is on this combination, potassium should be monitored. Third-line treatment options include vibradine, sacubitril valsartan, digoxin, hydralazine in combination with nitrate, and cardiac resynchronization therapy. For a vibradine, criteria include sinus rhythm greater than 75 per minute and a left ventricular ejection fraction less than 35%. For sacubitril valsartan, criteria is left ventricular ejection fraction less than 35% and is considered in HFrEF patients who are symptomatic on ACE inhibitors or ARBs. This should be initiated following ACE inhibitor or ARB washout period. Another option is digoxin. Digoxin has also not been proven to reduce mortality in patients with heart failure. It may, however, improve symptoms due to its inotropic properties, and it is strongly indicated if there is coexistent atrial fibrillation. Hydralazine in combination with nitrate. This may be particularly indicated in Afro-Caribbean patients. And lastly, cardiac resynchronization therapy. Criteria include patients with severely reduced ejection fraction, symptomatic on maximal medical therapy, and a widened QRS complex, for example, left bundle branch block on ECG. Other supportive treatments include influenza and pneumococcal vaccinations. Influenza vaccine is given annually, while the pneumococcal vaccine is given once. 5-year booster of pneumococcal vaccine is given to patients with asplenia, splenic dysfunction, or chronic kidney disease. Thanks for watching. Please like this video, share it with colleagues, and subscribe this channel.